Now let's briefly summarize key features of different container types. First type is list, represented by square brackets, and here could be different elements, for instance, integer, boolean, or string. This is list. Next, there are tuples, represented by pair of parentheses, and here could be same elements as in list, one, true, or let's say string. Also, there are dictionaries, represented by pair of curly braces, and dictionary has key-value pairs, for instance, key 1 has value 1, and key 2 has value string ABC. Also, there are sets, represented by same pair of curly braces, but sets only have values, for instance, 1 and ABC. Difference between those four types is following. Lists and tuples are ordered, and any element in list and tuple has its own index. Index starts with 0. Index of this element is 0, index of this element is 1, and so on. Difference between lists and tuples is that lists are mutable. You could change any value here, add new elements, remove elements, and so on. Tuples, on other hand, are immutable, and you are not able to modify those values, and also you are not able to add or remove elements from the tuple. Dictionaries and sets are unordered in Python. Order of the keys here does not matter, same as order of those elements in the set. And you could access any element in the dictionary by its key name, for instance key 1 or key 2, and also you could add new keys if you want to do so. Using del operator, you could remove specific key from the dictionary. It means that dictionaries are mutable, same as sets. You are able to mutate set, add new elements, remove elements, and so on. And difference of the set from the list is that list might contain same values, but set might contain only unique values. And if you attempt to add element, for example, ABC to this set, nothing will change, and set will still contain only two elements, 1 and ABC. That's the difference between four different container types: lists, tuples, dictionaries, and sets. Now let's exit from the Python interactive shell by calling exit function, and the remaining part of the course we will spend in the Visual Studio Code, and there we will talk about functions, if-else statements, and other Python features. In the remaining part of the course, I'll use Visual Studio Code Editor, because I'll create multi-line blocks of Python code and run it, and it's not a good idea to continue working in interactive shell, and that's why if you don't have VS Code installed on your computer, I highly recommend you install it as well, because we will use one of its extensions that will allow us to automatically execute Python code using keyboard shortcut or using Run Code button. So, if you don't have VS Code, please go ahead and install it from code.visualstudiocode.com. After installation, or if you already have VS Code installed, please open up any terminal application and let's create a folder for our project. I'll do that on the desktop and I'll create a new directory here and let's name it python-crash-course. Let me cd to this newly created folder. And let me open it up with help of code and dot command. If in your case this command is not available, you could open up VS Code manually and go there to file open and open this newly created folder there. So let me open it using this shortcut command. Here we are, project was opened in the Visual Studio Code, let me make it full screen and let me close this welcome page. Now let's create a single file here in this Python Crash Course folder. For that, click on this icon and let's name file main.py. Let's now close this left pane like that and let's write some Python code here in the main.py file. For instance, print hello from Python. Let's save changes and now question how to execute this Python application directly here in the VS Code. We could do that manually by going to terminal and click new terminal. New terminal was opened and notice that you are now in the Python Crash Course folder. That's why here please type Python and name of the file you want to run, main.py. You need to type such command if you are Windows or Linux user. If you are on Mac, please change Python to Python 3 like that. Let's press Enter and Python will interpret this file for you. And here is the result of the execution of this specific file. Hello from Python. But it's not convenient to run such command anytime when we'll make some changes in this file. That's why for simplicity let's install one of the VS Code extensions called Code Runner, and using Code Runner we will be able to run this code much more easier and faster using shortcut or this button here. Let's go to extensions, and here in extensions search for Code Runner. Select Code Runner and click install. Code Runner was installed, and if you scroll a bit down here in the description, you'll find how to run it. Let me search for a shortcut here, and here it is in the usage section. To run code, you could use shortcut Ctrl-Alt-N, or use this button here. Let's go to main.py file, and first let's click on this button, and select Run Code. And here I see result of running this file using Code Runner. I see such sections as running and done, and unfortunately I don't want to see them anytime when I run this program using Code Runner, and that's why in a moment I'll explain to you how to modify settings of Code Runner in order to avoid displaying of such messages. Also, we will clear our previous output anytime when we will run Code Runner again and again. Also notice here that on this line, Python interpreter was used on my computer, and if you are a Mac user, I'll explain to you how to change it from Python to Python 3. Let's go to Settings, Code Preferences Settings, or use shortcut Command comma or Control comma, and let's search here for Code Runner. You'll find settings that contain Code Runner somewhere in their description or title, and let's filter further, and let's add here filter Save like that. And you'll find two options: save all files before run and save file before run. I'll check this checkbox, and when you'll run any file using Code Runner, it will first automatically save the file and afterwards run the code. Now here let's search for clear like that and check this checkbox clear previous output. Now let's search for Code Runner message. And you'll find option show execution message, like running and done. Let's uncheck this checkbox. And if you are a Mac user, please enter Code Runner exec, and you'll find option Code Runner executor map. And you need to open settings.json file and edit the setting for Python interpreter there. Please click on edit in settings.json and search for Python here. And change Python-u to Python 3-u. And save changes in this settings.json file like that. Now we are all set, let's try to rerun our main.py file here. Let's click here, run code, and now I see only hello from Python. And if I modify a file and add here, for instance, exclamation mark like that, and save changes in the file, run it again, run code, I'll see that previous output was cleared. Also, you could use shortcut Ctrl-Alt-N in order to run code quicker. Let's modify file once again and press key combination Ctrl-Alt-N, and I see updated result here in the output. Hello from Python with two exclamation marks. Also, you could modify position of the terminal. Now by default it is under the file, and if you want to move it here to the right, you could right button click here and select move panel right, like that. And now terminal is open here on the right side of the file. It is more convenient for me. So, now we are all set, Code Runner is installed, and anytime when you want to run this code, you need to press key combination Ctrl-Alt-N like that.